Dr. Fan, and today in this video, I will demonstrate the titration of a monoprotic weak acid, acetic acid, with sodium hydroxide. For the sodium hydroxide solution, we already made the solution and standardized it. So from now on, we're going to work with the molarity of the sodium hydroxide solution that was established through the standardization process. And for standardizing the sodium hydroxide, we used the KHP. Also for today, we're going to remember that the pH probe that we're using for the titration process needs to go through a two-point calibration before it can be used for the experiment. And after calibrating my pH probe, I have it here. It will need to be linked through a Bluetooth connection with a suitable device, and today I will be using my iPad. For the titration, the first and most important thing is to have a burette filled with a titrant. And I already prepared my setup. I have a stand that has a burette clamp on it, and the burette clamp is holding my burette that contains my approximately 0.1 molar sodium hydroxide solution. Because I will be using a pH probe, additionally, I will add another clamp that will be dedicated to holding the pH probe in position. Because we want consistent stirring throughout the process, we're going to use magnetic stirring today. Here is a magnetic stir plate. I will need to raise my burette so I can slide the stir plate under it. I will need a 150 milliliter beaker with a magnetic stir bar in it. And if any of my connections are below the rim of the beaker, I need to raise them. It is important to check where the magnetic stir bar is going to move. And we want to localize it somewhere in a quadrant of the beaker so that we can position the pH probe away from it. This means that my magnetic stir bar will be between 12 and 3 on the clock dial sides. And that way I will place my pH probe at approximately 7 or 8. That's good. The next thing I am going to do is add my acid. For this titration, I am going to use the approximately 0.1 molar acetic acid solution. And I could use a pipette for measuring at the exact volume, or I can use a graduated cylinder if I am not concerned about the exact volume that I'm adding. Because with a graduated cylinder, it could be anywhere between 20 to 30 milliliters, and I can adjust it according to the experiment. Because an indicator responds to pH changes much faster than a pH sensor, I will be using universal indicator today. And whenever I am transitioning my pH probe between the original buffer solution and the experimental setup, I will rinse it with the ionized water and wipe it dry with Kim wipes. For this, I will need my deionized water, a waste container, and the Kim wipes. And throughout the process, we need to make sure that our device, which is connected to the pH probe, does not shut down. So let's get started. The first thing we are going to do is transfer the acetic acid solution inside our beaker. I will measure out approximately 25 milliliters. I have a little bit more than that. I have 25.6 milliliters of the approximately 0.1 molar acetic acid solution. I will transfer this into my beaker without spilling it. And with that, I am done with my acetic acid solution. The next thing will be placing the pH sensor or the pH probe inside the acetic acid. I'm going to just release some of that pressure that is here, extract the pH probe, take some deionized water, rinse off the buffer storage solution. And when the rinsing is complete, I will wipe it dry with some Kim wipes. Remember, not paper towels, because these sensors are very sensitive. And with that, I am going to slide my pH probe through the originally prepared clamp so that it sinks into the acetic acid solution. It should be relatively stable. And then once again, we check to make sure that the magnetic stir bar will not hit the pH probe as it's moving around. We're almost ready. There are two more things that we need to do. First, we're going to add some universal indicator to see the current color of our solution. Four drops should be more than enough to give us a bright color that will indicate the approximate pH of our solution. And our pH probe that is communicating with our device will tell us where the pH is currently. The first pH reading that we have is 2.86. And before we can begin with our titration, we need to know the starting volume of the sodium hydroxide inside our burette. So for that, we don't adjust ourselves, we adjust our burette. We can slide it all the way to the edge of the benchtop, move the burette onto the other side, rotate it so we can let it off the benchtop, and then slide it down so that the meniscus of our solution is at our eye level. Now that we have the sodium hydroxide solution's meniscus at our eye level, we record our measurement, and in our case, our starting volume is 0.21 milliliters. The first measurement will require quite a bit of adjusting. Additional measurements should be somewhat easier. And now we slide it around and make sure that the tip of our burette is going to be just below the rim of our beaker. And we can start with larger amounts of sodium hydroxide added. Begin with approximately 3 milliliters, and then as the titration progresses, lower that volume to 2 1-milliliter increments. And then once you are close and your pH starts to rise, it needs to slow down dropwise. And at that point, the change of the indicator is going to show you where that wait time needs to happen so that your pH probe can catch up with the pH measurement. So for now, we recorded our starting volume and we recorded our starting pH at 2.85, and we are ready to begin. The first addition did not cause much of a color change. It started out orangish. It's still in the orange range. The pH is 3.80, and the volume of our sodium hydroxide solution in the burette will need to be recorded. The volume after the first addition is 3.34 milliliters. Let's add another approximately 3 milliliters. The pH has increased somewhat. First, we record the volume. It is 6.69 milliliters, and the pH is 4.17. Our new volume of sodium hydroxide solution in the burette is 24.43 milliliters, and the pH is 5.62. I added one drop of the sodium hydroxide solution, and now the volume in the burette is 27.31 milliliters, and the pH is 7.20. I will add another drop. The solution is turning from greenish towards teal blue. The new volume of the solution is 27.37 milliliters. And the pH is at 7.51. I will add one more drop. The color changed from greenish to blue. And our new volume is 27.46 milliliters. The pH is still climbing. The pH now is 8.28. Let's add one more drop. And we see the second color change that is the response of a one-drop addition process, which means that we are at the equivalence point slightly above now. Our new volume is 27.51 milliliters, and the pH is above 9 and still climbing. The pH is 9.23. Let's add one more drop. The new volume is 27.59 milliliters, and the new pH is 9.61. This is where we can add a little bit more. Our new volume is 30.30, and the pH is 11.61. The new volume is 38.19. And the pH is 12.13. Another 3 milliliters. The new volume is 41.29, and the pH is 12.21. And then we add our final approximately 3 milliliter increment. The final volume is 44.39 milliliters, and the milliliters, and the pH is 12.28. We have three numbers above a pH of 12, so that should be enough for us to complete the S-shaped curve with a substantial tail on both sides.